Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well today, and welcome to anybody that's new. Everyone's welcome here. So we're doing pick a pile today, and it is how do they feel about the third party versus how they feel about you. So we'll do the third party first and then you guys, okay? So take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Don't force anything. If you feel it's not your pile, choose another pile. And these are energies here, okay? So if the King of Swords comes out, that could still be female, okay? So pile one, we have the pink pin here. Pile two, didn't even realize I chose two rubies, but never mind. We have a ruby pin, flower ruby pin. And pile three, we have another ruby pin. Anyway, I'll see you at your piles, guys. Hey, pile one, so if you chose the pink pin, this is your reading. So let's have a look. Right, so spirit, please tell me, what are their current feelings for the third party? What are their current feelings for the third party? What are their current feelings for the third party? Oh, jeez. Okay, straight off the bat, we have the Ten of Swords. So that's in shot. Then we have the Page of Swords. So I'm going to get a few more. So how do they currently feel about the third party for my pile one, spirit, please? And then we have the Three of Cups. We have the Star. We have the Devil. And then we have the Ace of Wands. And on the back of the deck, we have the Ace of Cups. Okay. So, hopefully that's in shot. Yes, it is. Right. Interesting. Okay, so from what I'm seeing here straight off the bat, guys, with how they feel about the third party, is there is love here. There's still love here, but there is, I am picking up strong, you know, marriage connection here. Like, this person could be in a serious committed relationship with them, you know, like common law man and wife, or they are married, okay? But something's happened with this third party here. The Ten of Swords is the ultimate betrayal, okay? Betrayal. So this is, you know, something that's happened in their connection here. I don't know. I'm getting a strong feeling here that there may have been some cheating here. Maybe not physical cheating, but online cheating. So their partner, whoever they're with, the third party, has maybe got an emotionally involved with somebody online. And I feel like this is not the first time it's happened. It's happened quite a few times. I do want to clarify that Ten of Swords, though, as well, because that can be like a complete ending, you know, like something comes to an end. Something, this became very toxic between the pair of them here with the Devil. So we've got strong Capricorn, strong Aquarius energy here. I'm just gonna say it, but where I mentioned about the online cheating, I feel like it was actually maybe online adult sites. and it may have got a bit out of hand with this person. I am picking up that they are addicted to sex here with the Ace of Wands. I sometimes see that as a, you know, a sexual card. So this, yeah, things has got a bit out of hand between both of them. So we have the Three of Swords as well. This is a broken relationship. This is like come to an end between the third party and this person here, or they're wanting to end it, they're wanting to walk away from them. But I don't know. Tell me about this Ten of Swords. But it could be that they also, from another scenario I'm seeing here, that even though they've been betrayed by the third party, they still feel very passionate about this person. Okay, there's still a lot of sexual chemistry between them. There's still a lot of passion, still a lot of love. Okay, and they would like to start again. You know, they would like to fix what was broken, basically. So tell me about the Ten of Swords. Oh, Queen of Cups. Tell me about the Ten of Swords. Yep. This third party had multiple options or was involved with multiple people, and I do believe this is a couple that are married here, and the Queen of Cups has stepped out of the connection. But what's really sad here, okay, they do feel very betrayed, like, by the third party, but I feel like this Queen of Cups has a strong hold on this person here, okay? It's like they know they're doing wrong, but they're still, it's like they're obsessed with this energy here, like the third party with the star here. You know, they still see them as someone. They put them on a pedestal, basically. It's like they could do no wrong. But I'm also picking up, like, what's the word? Like a lot of gaslighting here, or manipulation. So it's like this Queen of Cups will convince this person here that, you know, it's all in your head, it's not what it is, blah, 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 blah. And that's where the devil energy comes into it here. They've got a hold on this person, and they're good at what they do. Not meaning that in a boastful way. They're good at the control, because the Queen of Cups, she can be seen as very controlling and very possessive. You know, it's my way or the highway. And she also can be seen as unfaithful if seen in a negative light. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. Tell me about the devil energy here for my pile ones. Temperance. Hangman and Three of Pentacles. Yeah, look, they're trying to heal from this situation here. They are trying to really heal and bring balance back into this connection, because they are all over the place emotionally at the moment. They feel stuck with the Hangman here. They do tend to carry around a lot of the pain, you know, the idea that this person could do this to me. I mean, how can they do this to me? Blah, 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 blah. You know, but they're willing to sacrifice themselves. They're willing to just accept it for what it is, which is really sad, because there is a lot of love here and a lot of passion. But, you know, it's very sad. for some of you, you could actually work with this person and you've become very close with them. Okay, so that's for some of you. So you have a close bond with them at work. This could just be, you know, someone you met through work. So let's look at your, how they feel about you, okay? It's quite a sad situation, really. So Spirit, how does this energy currently feel about my pile ones? How are they feeling about my pile ones? Oh, jeez. Okay, calm down. Six of Cups. Five of Wands in reverse. Hope this is in the chart. I'm having a look. The Star again. Strong Aquarius energy here. Maybe you're an Aquarius. Hey, Aquariuses. and they're with an Aquarius as well. Seven of Swords. Ace of Wands. God, this person's a hot mess. And I don't mean that in a horrible way. Five of Cups. So how they feel about you guys? They reminisce a lot about the past. I feel like because of what is going on over here with the third party, they tend to slip back into reminiscing about your good times and how it was with you, both of you, okay? They remember the passionate times and the fun times and, you know, the energy that you brought into this connection. So yeah, they're doing a lot of reminiscing about the past here. What's that? Five of Wands in reverse. So it could be towards the end of your connection with both of you. You could have been arguing a lot, you know, fighting, a lot of conflict between both of you. Just not getting on, not seeing eye to eye. You know, there was a lot of challenges in your relationship when you were with this person. And it also could be if you worked with this person, you just found it wasn't worth, you know, pursuing anything with this person because this person had a lot of obstacles in the way. You know, they've got all this going on, you know, if they were married, it just wasn't worth the grief, you know. But I'm picking up strong, maybe childhood connection here, young love, innocent love here I'm picking up on. This is very confusing. They see you as the Star, okay? They saw you as wish fulfillment. They still see you as wish fulfillment, someone that they could have maybe, you know, they reminisce about what could have been with both of you, you know, where it would have gone if maybe the conflict wasn't there and the arguments, you know. They do reminisce a lot about this. But with the Seven of Swords, yes, this is sneaky behavior. They had to, like, you know, they know they have to turn their back on you or turn their back on this connection, you know, and stop thinking about it because you know they're in this situation now. There's nothing really they can do in this situation, but they do reminisce about you a lot. You did bring a lot of happiness and a lot of peace into their life at one stage is what they're saying. And they also, what I'm seeing here is that when you two broke up, it affected them very deeply. You know, they did grieve for a very long time after you two broke up. You know, this person feels so much regret for the way things turned out with you Yeah, it's very sad actually. I'm feeling very, very sad. And they stay up late here, and they do think about you a lot. You do cross their mind. They have dreams about you as well. So, any more spirit from a pile of ones? I'm not. I know this. Let me just get a few more cards before I say it. How do they currently feel about my pile one spirit? Work card again. There's strong work. Connection here. You could have met through work. They do remember you being very hard working, very supportive of others. Because if you look at this card here, what is that down there? Oh, they're so cute. Look at the frog. I'm so sad. I love frogs. You were very giving, very helpful. They do admire that still about you. I don't want to say it just yet. Just let me get one more card. So how do they currently feel about my pile ones? Spirit, stop taking the mic. We have the Ten of Pentacles and the Knight of Swords. Look, I don't see any love here for you guys, okay? I see a lot of hurt, pain, regret is what I see here for you guys, okay? The love is over here. Why? I don't know. Do you know what? Anyway. For you guys, okay, if this was a long time ago for some of you, they envy you, okay? Because the Ten of Pentacles here, you guys are actually, for my pile ones, are actually in a long-term commitment with somebody else. You've already laid down roots with someone, okay? You could be married, you could, the Ten of Pentacles is a family environment as well, so you could have a family of your own as well, okay? And I'm picking up, I am picking up envy and a bit of jealousy here because I don't know, maybe they didn't think that I don't know. I'm not gonna say that. It's not nice. I'm picking up a bit of resentment here because it's like, why is my life like this and your life is like that? I deserve it a bit more. So this person could have been a bit selfish when they were with you. Just the way they acted or sometimes the things that they said to you was quite hurtful and selfish. Yeah, the Knight of Swords, this person does admire this life of yours here. They see that you've made such big changes in your life here. You took action with somebody else, you moved forward with your life, you didn't sit around and like some people do and wallow in it. So yeah, I am picking up quite strong envy here. I'm not picking up any love, okay? I do feel like they still find you attractive, but not no love here. And I do feel like because it happened so long ago, they do still think about you because, you are part of their past and, they may wonder what you're doing now, and then they look online and they see you with your happy family, how well you're doing financially as well. So yeah, they know that sometimes they think that that could have been their life, but who knows? So let me get some message cards. So let's get some message cards from this energy from a pile one, please, Spirit. But their life is a mess at the moment with the third party. Total mess. And they're just accepting it for what it is, okay? They feel stuck in this position that they're in with this person, you know. But there is love and there is still passion there and they do want to fix things. At the time, I only cared about my feelings. I now regret that. And that's why I said selfish energy was what I was picking up here. I ghosted you whenever you needed me because I didn't want to boss up. Selfish energy again. I never meant to break your heart. I didn't think you cared. But now I see your love was real. Yeah, but it's too late now that they see your love was real. And that's just them trying to justify their actions or their behavior when they were with you, you know. I mean, I'm not really looking into what they did because that's not what this reading is. But the energy I am getting from your pile here is that they were quite selfish. And it says here, I think about texting you, but I stop myself. Okay. Yeah, because they know there would be consequences. And if you're in a relationship already, it wouldn't really be fair, would it? Let's just get some cards here for my pile one, please, Spirit. So we have secret pregnancy here. So it could be if their partner's been playing away here, the third party, they could actually have, could be pregnant by somebody, they could be pregnant by somebody else here that they're not aware of. Or it could have been maybe in your situation is that they got this third party pregnant, you know, if there was cheating involved. They don't feel good enough for you. Well, they can't control themselves around you. And maybe that's why they, you know, there is no contact here with both of you. And then we have, do you think of me? And then I am working on my finances before I come back to you. So maybe they're wanting to come back, but I don't really see that. Maybe that's just their higher self. I want to turn up at your house. Yeah, they'd love to, but I think if you're in a relationship, I think your partner would knock them out. But anyway, that's another story. But pile one, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this video, please hit like and you take care. Bye. Hey, pile two, so if you chose this ruby pin, this is your reading. So let's have a look. So spirit, angels, ancestors, tell me, how do they currently feel about the third party? How do they currently feel about the third party? Okay. I've got the Hierophant and the Princess of Swords. How do they feel about the third party? Princess of Wands. So this person's married. Oh, straight where I'm seeing that. This person's married. They have children. They could have a few children. They're in a committed partnership here. Children are involved. Devil energy. Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, they've got a life together. And Seven of Cups. And the overall energy is the Nine of Pentacles. So what I'm seeing from how they feel about the third party here is that they actually feel trapped with the third party. trapped in a situation because children are involved here. They've built a life together with the Ten of Pentacles, and these two could have been together for years with the Ten of Pentacles, okay? But they feel like there's something better out there for them, you know? They would like to look at other options, but obviously they're feeling trapped. It could be like a codependency relationship. You know, this energy's partner could rely on them for financial support, you know, because of the children here. It can be, you know, they're bound by marriage because it could be a religious thing as well. So religious factors could be involved here with their connection here. But their energy is they want to be on the, they want to be single. Very weird. Well, it's not weird when you think about it, but yeah, their overall energy is they would like to be single and not in this connection here. Tell me about this devil. And I feel like as well, because this card, even though it's a Hierophant, the way the Hierophant has got like looking, I see that as a telescope, even though it's a light. But and then we've got the Princess of Swords, which is the Page of Swords, which is a spying card. So they could be looking at other people online, okay? They could be looking at other options with the Seven of Cups here. They could even be maybe looking at you online if they're aware that you've got social media. You know, they could be looking at your photographs in secret. Okay, so let me just have a look. Tell me about the devil energy here. About the devil energy. Yeah, this person emotionally drains them, okay? They feel stuck. And it's like oh, don't know whether there's maybe this person could be violent in their connection. And sometimes this person needs to protect themselves from their partner. This partner could be suffering with some health issues, you know, mental health issues, you know, that kind of thing where they lash out. So they have to protect themselves from them. That's what I'm seeing here. But they also could be recovering from something. Tell me about the Four of Swords. Tell me about the Four of Swords. Yeah, their finances took a hit here. And the person they got involved with is is a karmic here, which this is, you know, the third party here. It looks like their finances may have taken a hit with within their connection here. You know, they may have had problems and they've had to start a new job here, okay? And fortune wasn't smiling on them at one stage. They were going through a very hard time from what I'm seeing here, okay? And it may have caused a lot of discord and arguments and, you know, grief within the connection between the both of them because of financial worries and, you know, maybe losing a job here. But they have gone into a stage of building their finances back up. But I'm not seeing any love in this connection, you know, with the third party, with the karmic. I'm seeing I'm just seeing somebody that is very drained, somebody that feels that they can't get out of this situation no matter what. It's like they have to stay there now. You know, if children are involved, they're doing it for their children. It could be that they've even moved house, they could have moved abroad, they could be living abroad as well. a little bit more. How do they feel about the third party spirit? How do they currently feel about the third party for my pole twos? How do they currently feel? Wow, these two are very immature when they it comes to communicating or the way they behave. It's I feel like they've got quite a few kids here, okay? Not just one or two. I feel like maybe four or five kids here, okay? But with these two, there is an immaturity between both of them, whether they're grown-ass adults. It's they don't know how to communicate with one another. You've got the Princess of Cups, which is somebody that can be, you know, doesn't know how to express themselves, can be quite immature or very immature. And then you've got the Prince of Cups here as well, which is that's the Knight of Cups. This is somebody that still has romantic feelings for this energy here. So they do have romantic feelings, but I don't feel like it's love. I don't feel like there's any passion there anymore. It's like it's died, okay? So anyway, let's have a look at how they feel about you. So spirit, tell me, how does this person feel about my pole twos? How do I currently feel about my pole twos? How do I feel about my pole two? King of Wands. Wow. How do they currently feel about my pole two? Wow. Okay. We have the Queen of Wands. We have a couple here. We have the Six of Wands. Two of Swords. The Hangman. Six of Pentacles. And Justice. I hope you can see that. And just overlap that, and on the back of the deck we have the Two of Pentacles here. You haven't seen this person for a long time is what I'm picking up here, pile two. Okay, you two once were, you know, a power couple. You two were hot shit, basically. You know, you both very, very attractive people. So we've got Capricorn energy, we've got a lot of air sign here, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. Taurus energy here, a lot of fire signs here, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius as well, Libra again. So a lot of air and a lot of fire here. But anyways, back to how they feel about you. You know, they once were very passionate about you, found you very sexy, very good looking. They loved your fire, you know, your passion for life or for anything that you were interested in. They found you very strong and independent as well. So there's still a lot of sexual chemistry here or sexual attraction here from this energy. Like, you know, I don't think that's ever gone away. And you two could have had a really good, you know, sex life, if you want to put it that way. You just match. So what went wrong? see the Six of Wands. This is like, you know, success, being, you know, victory, achievements here. And I feel like, I do feel like they are spying on you and they're seeing your achievements through life. And they really admire that still about you, you know, that I feel like they're very happy for you, you know. See the Two of Swords here, they've conflicted about this situation. Maybe they still question themselves, why did it not work out? It also could be that they regret not choosing you or remaining with you or marrying you, that kind of thing, you know. There is regret here. They know they messed up. And you know what, as well, they've now finally realised that, you know, they've got a new perspective on things here now. They've finally realised where I feel like they're looking at your social medias, or, you know, maybe you guys know people, you know, have people in common, okay, like friends and things like that. They now know that this would have been an equal partnership, whereas over here with the karmic, with the third party, it looks like they've had to provide for everybody here. You know, they've had to take on the stress of financial support, emotional support, you know, all that. That's a lot for someone to, you know, deal with. Whereas now they look over here and they think to themselves, we could have had it all together over here. You know, we would have been equals. It would have been an equal partnership, because we've got the King and Queen of Wands over here. Then you've got the Six of Pentacles. And, yeah, they now have this new perspective of it would have been equal give and take between the both of you. But they realise that this is all on them with justice here. You know, they know, and they're accepting the fact that they messed up. And I feel like they feel, you know, maybe this is their karma for, you know, not choosing you, not staying with you. It's actually kind of sad, really. So they do still hold a lot of passion for you guys, pile two. And they still find you very, very beautiful, very, very attractive, okay? I feel like what I said here about, I feel like they look at you online. So how do they feel about my pile two's here, Spirit? It's really sad. Three of Wands, Death, and the Wheel of Fortune. You know, this person could have juggled you. They could have even lied to you, okay? They could, you know, it could have been that they had an option between, a choice between you and this third party over here, okay? And they chose the third party because, like I said, it could have been for religious reasons or, you know, family pressures, outside pressures here, that they felt they had to choose this other person. And maybe they looked at you, you know, as somebody that wasn't really marriage material or settling down material, because I do feel like this person judged you in that sense, or they were convinced to look at you in the wrong way here is what I'm picking up. And there is such huge regret here for doing that. And the sad, really sad thing is about this is that they know this is ended here, okay? They know this was destined to happen this way. It was fate. It had to happen like this. They know there is no way of, you know, reversing anything now because they're stuck in this situation here. But there is such longing for you. You know, they still really do yearn for you. you know, and they look at what could have been, what ifs, you know, there is a lot of ifs and buts and, you know, that kind of thing that goes on with this person. Yeah, look, with the Seven of Swords for you guys, this person was a bit sneaky when it, maybe they didn't tell you about the third party over here, but they were very sneaky in their behaviour, okay? And I feel like they may have lied to you. But they were under pressure with something here. They were under pressure. They had to make a decision and they chose this path. So let's get some messages from this energy here for you. So what messages do you have from a pile two? So I ghosted you whenever you needed me because I didn't want to boss up. So it could be, which is unusual for the King of Pentacles or the Queen of Pentacles, because they are strong and they are a boss, you know, but it could have been that they may have had to ghost you because if they were, you know, trying to get their head right in regards to the third party, they didn't want to obviously face the truth or didn't want to tell you the truth, because we do have the Seven of Swords there. Oh my God. I ghosted you trying to chase other options. Okay, we're getting that loud and clear, love. So there was a lot of ghosting in your connection here. It may have been that, I don't know why I've just heard, you feel used, pile two. Like you feel that they used you and they lied to you. So they'd spend time with you, but then they'll ghost you because they were dealing with another connection. You know, they may not have been married, but they were dealing with somebody else, which was the third party. And then they would get to see you when they could see you. So I feel like they never told you about the third party. I feel like they took the chicken shite way out of it, if you know what I mean. And I feel like, you know, I feel like you two were high level soulmates here and they messed up big time, and it could be that's what's being shown to them now. You know, we've got the Hangman, you know, that's enlightenment, and we've got the Hierophant here as well. And I do believe they now notice that the path that they chose was not correct, you know, wasn't right. And I do believe they are receiving karma for either what they did to you or for, you know, maybe not choosing the path that they should have chosen. Because, you know, we've got a lot of devil energy here. We've got a lot of financial struggles here. They've even got the karma card as well. I want to come back to you, but they know they can't. I'm letting other people get in my head about us. And this is exactly what I said, that this is what happened. I feel like maybe they tried to speak to somebody about you and they convinced them to go down this path, you know. They settled for a safer option is what I'm hearing. And then on the back of the deck we have, I think about texting you, but I stopped myself. Yeah, because they'll be opening a can of worms that shouldn't be opened, basically. So they are just a side piece, but I feel like that's too, it's not nice to hear my pile twos, but this is what I was saying. I feel like you were used, that you were just the person on the side. Okay, so this is their higher self telling you that you were just a side piece at the time, but they caught feelings here. So they're telling you that they have secret online dating apps, so they maybe they're not faithful to their partner. It could even be they have not necessarily dating apps, it could be they, oh my God, they look online at you, you know. The karmic has me trapped. No shit, Sherlock. I cry at night over losing you. And they now realize that your love for me was always unconditional. So yeah, there's huge regret here on their part, but they're trapped. There's nothing they can do. So my pile two, I'm going to leave it there. You have a lovely day and you take care. Bye. Hey, pile three, so if you chose this ruby pin, this is your reading. So let's take a look at how they currently feel about the third party. So spirit, how do they feel about the third party for my pile threes? How do they currently feel about the third party? Queen of Swords. Sagittarius. Air sign here. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Fire sign, Leo, Aries. Sagittarius. Tower. How do they currently feel about the third party? What is going on with pile three? And the overall energy is the Queen of Cups. So there's been some disharmony, well, not some, quite a lot of disharmony in this connection here. And I'm picking up that these two people are like opposites attract, you know, they're total opposites of one another here. So how they feel about the third party is that they see the third party as being very like cold, defensive, you know, their guard's always up. There's some kind of betrayal here, or unhappiness here as well. There's some kind of deception going on here. You know, a lot of sneaking around or a lot of lying. Could be cheating as well. There's been a lot of sleepless nights over this connection here as well. A lot of tears have been shed over this connection. And with the tower, that's like devastation, you know, that's you know, like a, there's been a big change in this connection here. Actually, what I'm actually seeing here is as well is that this energy here once had so much passion for this connection, you know, a lot of love. You know, they felt so much love for this person, so much passion for this person, for the third party. But now their defenses are up. It's like they've gone cold towards this connection because of these three cards down here. Let me have a look. Tell me about the tower. Being a bit nosy here. Tell me about the tower. Oh, somebody stepped out in this connection. Either the person that you're inquiring about or the third party stepped out in this connection. That's why the Seven of Swords is there. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Because the Queen of Wands can be seen as the other woman. Yeah, look. either chose somebody else or they were looking elsewhere. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Yeah, Judgment. Some sort of clarity was brought on, you know, that they were made aware of in regards to their partner here. You know, the Queen of Wands can be seen as, you know, Jezebel or the other woman, or, you know, stepping out of a connection here. Spirit, tell me, did the third party cheat? Did the third party cheat? Yes or no? Let's see who it was. I'm just being nosy, guys. Did the third party cheat? Oh my god, I can't shuffle, for goodness sake. Okay. I take that as a yes. I take that as a big yes from Spirit. The third party cheated. And this was kept in the dark from the King of Wands here, okay? This is why their defences are up with with their partner, because they've been deeply wounded. This has affected them quite deeply, you know. I feel like they didn't believe that their partner... Why am I stuttering, for God's sake? They didn't believe that their partner was capable of doing something like this to them. And I am totally just, like, losing my words here. And this was kept in the dark from them, and I feel like this was going on for a long time. It wasn't just like a fling. This was a long, long time thing, okay? It could be that the Queen of Wands is, you know, they could be addicted to sex. This is a couple here. We have King, Queen, you know, Queen of Wands as well. So, yeah, devil energy. And the thing is as well, what they've realised now, that this person is very, very greedy, okay? That it's not about love for her or him, because don't forget, these are energies, okay? This is about material wealth, basically, you know, the good things in life, the abundance that this King of Wands brings to the table, because the King of Wands is very successful. You know, they do very well for themselves. And the Ten of Pentacles is... You know, like generational wealth and a long-term commitment here with children, so they could have children. But this Queen of Wands is very toxic, okay, which would explain a lot with the Queen of Wands. She's very malicious. She really has a... I feel like this King of Wands is a bit scared of the Queen of Wands, okay? Maybe she's threatening him, you know, with the devil energy here. She could be very manipulative and spiteful. And with the devil energy here, this is somebody that is unfaithful, okay? Wow. So, this person sees this Queen of Wands as nothing but a money-grabbing, whatever you want to add to that at the end. It'd be a cheater, someone that's very unfaithful. Someone they can't trust. Their guard is up now. There's coldness between these two now with the Queen of Swords. You know, they're starting to see now that... they're starting to see through the Queen of Wands BS, basically. They can now see when she's lying, you know, or trying to be clever, you know, that kind of thing. So, yeah, they're really not happy. But I feel like they're holding on because they've invested so much into this connection here. Whether they'll hold on for much longer, I don't know. Because they are looking at, they are calling judgment on this connection here. It could be that they've decided, you know what, I'm done with this now. Because this is bringing about clarity here. This is choosing a different path, you know, what's right for them. So they are looking to the future. They are looking to maybe take a different direction. But there's a lot at stake here with finances here, you know. So let's look at how they feel about you. So, Spirit, tell me, how does this person currently feel about my pile three? How do they currently feel about my pile three? Oh, jeez. We have the Hermit. The Fool. Let's get a few more. How do they currently feel about my pile three? We have the Eight of Swords. Eight of Wands, sorry, not Eight of Swords. Knight of Pentacles. Nine of Wands in reverse. Let's get one more. Sort of Taurus energy here as well. How do they feel about my pile threes? God, do you know what these cards indicate me? Two of Pentacles. The Emperor, I'll put that there, the Moon, and on the back of the deck, Eight of Cups, and Ace of Swords as well. Well, how they feel about you is they would really like for, they are looking to you to maybe start again with the Fool, you know, maybe is there a chance of, you know, you know, a chance of a new beginning with you, you taking that leap of faith, or them taking that leap of faith towards you. They do think about this new beginning with you, with the Hermit here. There is a lot of thinking going on when it comes to you. There is a lot of thinking of whether they should contact you or not here, or there's a lot of contemplation on whether they should take action towards you with the Eight of Wands as well. They really do want to. But at the moment, they're trying to juggle their life. They're trying to juggle, you know, if they're going for a separation over here. I don't see a separation at the moment here. They're in the process of maybe, like, I don't know, thinking about it over there. But they do, they're drawn back to, well, no, they've always been drawn to you, but obviously they chose a different path to you. This is why we're doing this reading. So yeah, they've got a lot that they need to fix first before they can come forward. So we have the Nine of Wands in reverse. See, this person's being very stubborn at the moment. And it's like they're weighing up their options here. Should I? Shouldn't I? Am I going to get rejected? Do I contact my pile threes? So they're back and forth with this here. They want to take action, but they're not. It's like they don't have the balls to do it. And they're taking so long in making a decision when it comes to this, that just you're really taking their time here. You know, they don't want to make a mistake with you. That obviously, maybe they don't want to drag you into anything here, but they've been thinking about this for a very long time, of reaching out to you here and maybe hoping to renew the connection with you. There is huge regret here for walking away from you. You know, they do regret that. They also, you know, you've got the Divine Masculine here, the Emperor, Aries energy here. There is Aries Pisces here. This Emperor here still has a lot of hidden feelings for you, okay? Very deep, deep feelings for you. And I don't feel like they've ever told this third person over here. You know, they want to speak their truth. They want to come forward and, you know, talk to you, communicate with you, express how they feel, you know, but they feel stuck at the moment. They feel like they can't take that step towards you because of, obviously, they've got so much going on in their life. So let's get a few more here. So how do they feel about my pile threes? So the feelings for you at the moment is that there's, you know, they really do want to reach out. They want to talk, you know, maybe even to just tell you how their life's been going, you know, someone to, you know, just talk to, catch up. Yeah, look, Ten of Pentacles and the Chariot. They now realise they gave the Ten of Pentacles to the wrong person here. The family, starting a life with someone, building a home, getting married. They now know that it should have been with you, that they should have had this with, not this Queen of Wands over here. And they still do want this. They do still want this with the Chariot. You know, they want to take action. They want this to, you know, they'd like to put this into some kind of action here. You know, they want to be able to give to you, give to this connection, you know. Let's have a look. I'm just going to be nosy. What action is this? This energy going to take towards the pile three, spirit? No, spirit, come on. It's a whole bloody deck. What? Three of Swords, King of Cups. Look, they're dealing with a third party here. They really want to come towards you here, but you know, they have this love for you still that they carry with them, like I said about the moon. But they're dealing either with a breakup at the moment, or they're dealing with the third party at the moment. But I do feel like they're dealing with a lot of heartbreak here. But there is huge regret here, you know. You know, they're thinking with the Eight of Swords. They feel like they're trapped. They're all, you know, they're all up in their head thinking, you know, can I have this with my pile three, or is it just a dream? So let's just get a couple more. How are they currently feeling about my pile three? Justice in reverse. You know what, it's very sad really. They're denying their feelings for you. You know they have love for you, but they're trying to not, if you know what I mean, they're trying to ignore it basically. And now they really do realize that they ended up with a karmic, basically, that you know, this is like karmic injustice here. You know, and with justice in reverse as well, this is like they're in an abusive situation here, and it just like, yeah, they can't move towards you here. It can't happen. Not right now anyway. I don't see that happening now, because they can't stay, you know. They've got other commitments, they've got other things going on in their life here. So let's get some messages from them to you. I'm not sure if you want to talk to me, and this is the problem. They're really up in their head here about, you know, they're feeling so insecure about whether to reach out to you, because the fear of fear of rejection, basically. And I'm stuttering a lot in this reading, and this is how I feel like this person would actually act around you if they were to speak to you again. They would stutter, fall over their words, because they would feel very nervous, you know, and they're not sure whether you would want to talk to them, you know, if things ended badly. They're saying, don't hate me. Bless them. I do feel really bad for this energy here. I don't tell you how I truly feel because I don't want you to judge me. Yeah, because it could be, if they were to come forward, they may hold back on their feelings. You know, if they ever do reach out to you here, they're very tempted to. They may not tell you how they feel because they don't want you to look at them in a way of like, well, you know, that's not right if you're married or in another connection with the third party, you know. They don't want the judgment. Let's get a few more. My love for you is deeper than I let on, and that's with the moon card there, guys. You know, they don't tell people how they truly feel about you. I feel like they protect this from other people. I'm letting other people get in my head about us, but that could have been what happened, you know, in the beginning with your connection here. And it could even be, maybe they are trusting somebody and going to them and saying, what should I do? Should I reach out? And this person's telling them no, you know. So they're getting a bit confused there. So that could be another scenario. I've made terrible mistakes in our connection. Yeah, and they now realise that. And they're saying, I can't stand the thought of you with someone else. Yep. So let's get a few more messages here. Karma is kicking my butt for what I put you through. Yeah. That, you know, with justice in reverse as well, explains a lot. So what messages do you have from their higher self spirit, from a pile of three? Camel. Please unblock me. So it could be some of you have got this person on block and they have tried to reach out. I cannot sleep without you next to me. And it could be they actually may have found out the cheating was with an STI or, you know, an STD, you know, from their partner. I'm just going to get a couple more. Sex with you is magical. And sex addiction. So it could be that their partner has the sex addiction because, you know, the Queen of Wands, she is seen as a Jezebel, you know. Or it could be that they're addicted to sex with you, you know, or they were. So I'm going to leave it there, my pile three. If you like this reading, please hit like, and you take care and have a lovely day. Bye.